Hi, I'm Will Ackworth, and we're here at Expo Today Live with Rosario Chiarenza, a vice president in the legal department at Barclays. So thanks for joining us, Rosario.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
Now, I understand you're going to be talking later on today about CEF readiness. Yes. That's the readiness of these new swap execution facilities to offer their services to the public. I believe we already have 12 of them here in this exhibit hall presenting their services and talking about their platforms. Now, you've been talking with a lot of people, working with these CEFs to get everyone ready to use them. Can you give us a sense for just how the overall community is ready to start using these platforms? And let's start with the buy side, if you don't mind.
Sure. So I think there's definitely differences between buy-side actors in terms of their readiness. Mm-hmm. You have some of the larger buy-side participants, some of the larger asset managers who have given a lot of thought to transitioning to a CEF environment. So I would say that they are probably further along the curve. And you have some of the hedge fund community that's also similarly active traders in OTC derivatives. But for the most part, the vast majority of the buy side, I would say, is not ready for different reasons, technology, infrastructure, and just an understanding of how the CEF market will work.
Well, you know, the mandate is coming fairly soon. I believe Gary Gensler said yesterday here at this conference that first quarter of 2014 is his estimate. So does that mean we're going to see this huge crush of people rushing to banks, to the CEFs, to the FCMs, to onboard before the deadline?
That's an excellent observation, and I fear that is likely to be the case, especially with the broad submissions that some of the CEFs have made in terms of their made available to trade determinations. It'll cover a vast majority of the rates market, for example. That unless something changes between now and February, that's likely to be the case.
So let's talk for a moment about how the intermediaries are getting ready for this. So just off the top of your head, how many CEFs are you actually engaged with? I mean, how many are there in your universe?
So I've heard estimates of between 18 and 20. I think that's about the right number. There's always new applications that are submitted. In terms of, from a Barclays perspective, I think we've engaged with nearly all of the CEFs in some manner. We may not be signed on to the rule books of all the CEFs, but we've definitely had conversations with all of them. And I think that's probably the case for all the major dealers, both the execution desks and the FCM side. I certainly want to at least understand each of the CEF's business model and then make your determination from there in terms of which you prioritize and which you ultimately connect
sure.
to.
Does that mean you've actually read 18 rule books?
Sad enough, pretty close. We have a team of lawyers working on the rule books, but FIA actually has done tremendous work in this space in terms of organizing a group to review the rule books, to create charts, and that's been one of the largest issues in terms of just onboarding for October 2nd was
right.
just getting through all the
sure.
rule books. So it's definitely a heavy lift.
Well, if you could just give me a sense in your sort of crystal ball, do you think that over time we're going to see all these CEFs converging towards one sort of standard market model, one kind of common approach to various type of protocols and legal contracts, or instead are we going to continue to see a lot of experimentation and divergence in how people sort of address certain typical problems that one would encounter?
Right. I think the answer is both. And I think the answer should be both. There should be some standardizations in terms of the workflow and operational components
right.
that will obviously help for interconnectivity, both from the participants to the CEFs, CEFs to the CCPs.
Right.
And there's really no reason for innovation, or not innovation, but divergence or competition on those types of aspects. But in terms of trade and platforms and products that are offered, we look forward to the CEFs competing on that type of product and work. So I think it's a little bit of both.
A little bit of both. Well, look, it's great talking to you. Thank you so much for joining us. And thank you all for listening into Expo Today Live.